5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello everyone, I'm so glad to give you a presentation today. I'm delighted to introduce to you our quantum finance-based hybrid deep reinforcement learning portfolio investment system. Nowadays, both financial modeling and deep learning have limitations in generating trading strategies. For mathematical and financial modeling, they rely on assumptions that generally oversimplify the problem. For deep learning, model performance highly depends on prediction accuracy. This all requires experienced traders to make final decisions, and it has defeated the original objective of automatic trading. Based on the discussion above, current studies call for model-free automatic trading system. Reinforcement learning consists of agents that keep on making interaction with the environment to learn an optimal policy by trial and error, provides a possible solution. Therefore, we propose a system specially designed for portfolio management, consisting of two core parts. The first part is a deep deterministic policy gradient agent. It is used to generate appropriate investment weight vectors to maximize the expected accumulated return. The second part is a policy gradient agent trained by the same observation spaces in order to select the key quantum price level. Next, some related works. Integrating quantum field theory and an harmonic oscillatory model, Raymond has proposed QPL as an innovative indicator of market information. It could be effectively applied in financial market predictions. Since the motion and dynamics of these financial particles are subjected to their intrinsic quantum energy levels, QPL could be used to design trading strategies as analog to the resistance and support lie in technical analysis. About deep reinforcement learning in financial trading, Jiang and his team propose a model-free deep reinforcement learning framework consisting of a portfolio vector memory and implementing the DPG network with CNN, RNN, and LSTM to find the best backtest result. A combination of PG with adversarial training method proposed by Liang and his team also enable them to construct a profitable portfolio investment system. In this part, I will show you the methodology of our system. Firstly, quantum finance theory, like physical particles, dynamics of worldwide financial instruments can be modeled as financial particles. Therefore, financial particles also have equivalent states, and if there is external stimulus to excite particles, they will move to another higher or lower energy level. To calculate QPLs, we need to solve quantum finance Schrödinger equation. The first term is kinetic energy. The price return R is used to make the measurements of particle movement. It replaces the displacements in classical quantum mechanics. The second term is potential energy, which stimulates five main market participants: investors, speculators, arbitrageurs, hedgers, market makers, and their contribution to market volatility. After obtaining QPLs, we develop a quantum price level inspired risk control mechanism. The basic usage of QPL is to estimate the range of price movement and then take corresponding action. There are three types of actions based on QPL 1's choose and hold the order. Here I use three examples to illustrate this decision. In the first condition, the range from QPL 1 to 2 is between that day's high and low. If QPL 1 is evaluated as the most important factor for the decision, and then the agent will close orders of current products at QPL 1. Similarly, if QPL 2 is selected, the order would be closed at QPL 2. If the holding decision is made, the order of current product is kept. In the second condition, not both QPLs are within the interval constituted by low and high. In this case, making decision based on QPL 1 is the same as in the first condition. But for QPL 2, once it's selected, the agent will hold the current orders, since we think the current price hasn't reached the equivalent level. And then in the third condition, neither QPL nor 2 within the range from low to high. In this case, the only choice is to hold the order. If we select N plus 1 assets to be traded in the portfolio, the closing price of them could be comprised of price vector and period T, denoted as VT. VIT indicates the I assets closing price at period T. A special term, V0T in a portfolio, is called credit currency, indicating the remaining balance used for purchasing other forex products. As a risk-free asset, its value is always at 1. Moreover, we define price relative vector of T trading period as YT, where I is an integer indicating the selected QPL. The elements of YT indicate the potential of closing price for each asset in period T. If we define the portfolio value at the end of the period T as PT, then PT minus 1 indicates the portfolio value at the beginning of period T. The cumulative return capital R at time T is RT equals to PT over P0, and the return U at time T is PT over PT minus 1. In the real world market, transaction costs may overweigh returns, resulting in further loss. Hence, it is necessary to introduce transaction costs to stimulate a real world market. At the beginning of period T, the portfolio weight is WT minus 1. Since price movement always happens in the market, the weight vector will change correspondingly into W prime T, where this character indicates the element-wise multiplication. Assume the commission rate is the constant, capital C, then the cost at time T is given as mu T. The return at time T and cumulative return from T0 to capital T can be given as UT and capital RT. According to what mentioned above, we now can give the formal definition about a range of terms that would be used in deep reinforcement learning. For state, a two-dimensional observation space is built in our model with a shape M times N, where M represents the number of products contained in the portfolio, and N stands for the size of starting window. For each row, the state space is consists of PI, where PI corresponds to market information of I products in portfolio, and I is within the range from 1 to M. For action, it is expected is the expected weight vector at time T, which is given as WT. For reward, we use logarithmic rates of return considering transaction cost as return function RT. Okay, next, now I'm going to explain the deep deterministic policy gradient algorithm. This model consists of two critic and actor networks. In order to build a DDPG agent, we need to first initialize the online actor and critic network, and then copy the parameters to the corresponding target network. In the process of training the agent, depending on the current state, the online actor will generate an action based on its policy. And then the environment receives the action AT, make feedbacks with reward RT and the next state ST plus 1. After that, the online actor stores the transition into replay buffer. Next, the overflow will sample a batch of transitions with size n from the replay memory buffer. With these transitions, we are able to calculate the gradient of online critics and then update the parameters. After that, we also need to calculate the gradient of online actor and then update its parameters. Lastly, we soft update the parameter of target network. Now let's continue to policy gradient. We utilize this overflow to do risk control. Previously, we mentioned three types of action. This process is implemented by PG. Firstly, we define a trajectory tau, and then the probability of each trajectory can be calculated through this formula. The goal of PG agent is to maximize the cumulative expected return. The actions of policy gradient agent at time t is divided using vector AT, where each element in AT corresponds to the probability of each type of decision. Lastly, the action will be sampled by the policy. Next, let me show you the system implementation. First, I will give an overview about our system architecture. As the figure shown, sensing the current state ST, the DDPG agents would respond with current action AT, which is the desired wave vector at time t. After PG agents make decision about holding the orders or closing activating orders based on a specific QPL, it will receive the wave vector WT given by the DDPG agent. For both agents, WT is used in calculating the return with the predefined constant commission rate, capital C. Transition cost could be estimated, and then cumulative rewards are computed accordingly. After updating the parameters of both agents, the current iteration is completed. For the experimental settings, I have trained two agents for 100 apples, and there are 9 products in the portfolio. In order to compare the performance of our system with previous method, we selected two model-based strategies and two reinforcement learning models as the baseline. For our system, we implemented two versions. In the first version, the policy gradient agents only generate two actions, holding and close orders at QPL1. In the advanced version of our system, the PG agents can generate one more action, that is closing order at QPL2. About the experimental result, as the table shown, in terms of final accumulated portfolio value, the advanced version of our system has the best performance, whose final portfolio value is 3 times more than the original one. This shows the powerful probability of our system. Also, our two systems' sample ratios both reach significantly high levels, while baseline models' sample ratios are still less than 1. This demonstrates our model's strong ability in risk control. Moreover, as our advanced version performs better than the original one, we believe that the large action space indeed contributes to the exploration of PG agent, further helping achieve a higher portfolio value. The result of backtesting is shown in the figure. We can see that in the first half period, it's almost all the baseline model plateaued, but our system achieved considerable profits. In the second half period, our two models witnessed a continuous increase. Although almost all the baseline models are able to make profit, our system's profit achieved a significantly high level, shows its profitability and robustness. In order to further test the robustness, we select other 9 unseen products to do the backtesting. As shown in the figure, our two models maintain their profitability. However, for the sole DDPG agent, its overall performance is worse among all the models. This comparison obviously shows that PG agent indeed cooperate with the DDPG agent and prevent potential loss by closing order at an appropriate time. In summary, through implementing two cooperated DRL agents, our portfolio manager system shows superior performance in making profits over a range of previous methods, shows in either test datasets or unseen datasets. Quantum finance portfolio investment has its potential in trading, and we are also considering improving it with multi-agent mechanism. This is our reference. Thank you.